Children, this is question number, block number 6. Highest common factor, right? And children, we are already discussed this in the last period. We are already discussed this. But thing is, worksheet I have discussed, the lesson I told you to do yourself. So I want to check how best you are done and how many of you are done correctly. If you are done it, please check your answer with my answer. If you are not understood how it is to be done, please listen to this explanation and cross check your answers, steps, right? See, divisibility test by 11, first lesson under block 6. So the first question is related to divisibility test of 9 and 5. Of course, the name of the lesson is divisibility by 11. But under that, we learned all the divisibility tests. Before this video clip, I have sent you the table. I have explained you the table. In that full table, I have explained you the divisibility of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11. So, we should circle the numbers which are divisible by 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers are given. Out of these 5 numbers, some numbers are divisible by 9. Those numbers we should circle. Out of these 5 numbers, some numbers are divisible by 5. In these, some numbers are divisible by 5. Those numbers we should tick mark. Let us go through the table now. Recall the table which you learnt already. To do this, you should know the table, divisibility test table. What is the rule of divisibility by 9? Divisibility by 3 and 9 both are same. We should add the sum of the digits. So divisibility test of 9, let us start. Add these 4 plus 1, 5. 5 plus 5, 10. No, it is not divisible by 9. Is this divisible by 5? Rule you must notice, rule of divisibility by 5. In the ones place, if you find 0 or 5, then that number is divisible by 5. In the ones place, 0 or 5, 5 is there, yes. In the ones place, if you find 5, the whole number is divisible by 5. What we should do? We should tick. So tick marked. Tick marked are all divisible by 5. Same children, in the ones place, if you find 0 or 5, in the ones place, if you find 0 or 5, the total number is divisible by 5. But interestingly, this 450 is divisible by 9. Let us check. 4 plus 5, 9. 9 plus 0 is 9. This is divisible by both 9 as well as 5. What you will do, children? If it is divisible by both, what you will do? What we'll do is, we'll circle it. Circle to say that it is divisible by 5, and also it is divisible. Circle to say it is divisible by 9. Also tick mark because it is divisible by 5 also. Both. Right? Okay. 784. Only in the ones place, if it is 0 and 5, then only it is divisible by 5. There is no 0, there is no 5. This is not divisible by 5. Let us check whether it is divisible by 9 or not. How? Add the digits. 7 plus 8, 15. 15 plus 4, 19. 19 should be divisible by 9. No. 7 plus 8 plus 4, 19. 19 is not divisible by 9. 19 is not divisible by 9. So, you should not circle, and either you should not circle it or you should not tick mark it, because it is not divisible by 9 and it is not divisible by even 5. Okay. 990 is divisible by 5, because in the ones place you will find 0, so it is divisible by 5. Let us check whether it is divisible by 9 or not. 9 plus 9 plus 0 is 18 is divisible by 9, therefore this 990 is divisible by 9, circle it, and also it is divisible by 5. Interestingly, two numbers are given here, those two numbers are both divisible by 9 and divisible by 5, therefore we have to circle and we have to tick mark, there is no other option. Let us see this last one. Definitely it is not divisible by 5, because there is no 0 and 5 in the ones place. Only we have to check whether it is divisible by 9 or not by adding digits. 1 plus 0 plus 7 plus 9. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 7, 8. 8 plus 9, 17. So 17 is not divisible by 9. So this number is not divisible by 5 and 9. Therefore, no need to circle and no need to tick mark. Please check your answers. Now, the main part, divisibility test. We are doing divisibility test here. Whether this number is divisible by 11, you should not divide it to check this. Clearly it is said, use divisibility test of 11. We should use divisibility test. Here you should not divide by 11 to answer this. No. Children, to write answer easily, I have prepared a table. If you want, you can prepare a table. It is easy for you to get the answer if you prepare the table. See here, 1789. Write it in the place value chart, that you will do. No, 9 in the ones place, 8 in the tens place, 7 in the hundredth place, 1 in the thousandth place. This part you will do. Where is 9 in the first place? First is odd. Where is 8? 8 is in the second place. Second means even, 2 means even. No, where is 7? 7 is in the 1, 2, third place. Third, 3 means odd. 1 odd, 2 even, 3 odd, that is first place, second place, third place, fourth place, 4 is even. So, this is in the odd place, even place, odd place, even place. This is very important to note that, mark that, it is important to mark which are odd and which are even, because we are adding them separately. Let us add odd numbers, that is, sum of odd numbers. We should select only odd numbers. 9 is odd, 7 is odd, 9 plus 7 is 16. Next, sum of even numbers. Now this time we should select only even numbers. 8 plus 1 is 9. Children, previously I have taken one example and I said that if both are same, then you can decide this number is divisible by 11. If they are not same, I said that you should find the difference. Subtract now. Difference. Difference means subtraction. 16 minus 9. Children, 16 minus 9. 16 minus 9 is how much? 6 and 3, 7. 16 minus 9 is 7. This 7 is not divisible by 11. 7 is not divisible by 11. Even the answers we got, they are not same. Therefore, the number 1789 is not divisible by 11. Is not divisible by 11. You can say clearly. See, clearly you can say. because the sum which we are getting is not same and the difference is also not divisible by 11. Okay, let us see one more. Again, 34,786. Write down this in the place value chart. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, ten thousand. Ones place 6, tens place 8, 100 place 7, 1000 place 4, 10,000 place 3. This is in the first place. First means odd, 1 means odd. Second place, second means 2, 2 means even. Third place, third means 3, 3 is odd. Fourth place, 4 means even. This is in the fifth place. Fifth place, 5. 5 is odd. Now find the sum of odd numbers. Sum of odd numbers. Odd is 6. One more odd is 7. One more is there. Total 3 are there. Odd. 3. So 7 plus 3, 10. 10 plus 6, 16. 3 odd numbers. 6 plus 7, 13 plus 3, 16. Next, sum of even numbers. Sum of even numbers. Find out sum of even numbers. Even here it is 8. One more even is 4. 8 plus 4 is 12. Children, again we are not getting same number here. So, if it is not same, we should subtract. That is a difference. The difference here is 16 minus 12 is 4. 16 minus 12 is 4. This 4 is also not divisible by 11. If it is divisible by 11, then we can say that this number is divisible by 11. Now we can say that this 34,786 is not divisible by 11. You can say that it is not divisible by 11. You write down, children, one sentence. 34,786 is not divisible by 11. Let us see this. Both are not divisible by 11. So look at this. 56,408. Return the place value chart. First place means odd. Second even. Third odd. Fourth even. Fifth odd. Now sum of odd numbers. Sum of odd numbers. So add the odd numbers. Odd is 8. One more odd is 4. One more last odd is 5. When you add all these, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 5, 17. Now let us find out sum of even number, even places actually. Sum of even numbers, actually even places. You can write even places, odd places, even places, odd places, even places, odd places, even places. Even places are 0 plus 6. 0 plus 6, 0 plus 6 will be 6. Now again we are not getting same number. One is 17 and another is 6. But immediately don't decide that it is not divisible by 11. One more step, one more time we should check, that is by difference. Difference is 17 minus 6 is 11. See children, very carefully you can observe. This time I got 11. 11 is divisible by 11. 11 once 11. 11 is divisible by 11. Therefore, you should say that 56,408 is divisible by 11. Is divisible by 11. This third one is divisible by 11. Here it is not, because this 4 is not divisible by 11. Here also 7 is not divisible by 11. But 11 is divisible by 11. Understood, children? Okay. These are the second question answers. Let us see the last one. Here also some digits are missing. No problem, we'll find out the digits. First, start with sum of, same steps you follow. I have written that given number in the place value chart. 4, 5. First digit is missing, 1's place is missing, 10's place 2, 100 place is missing, 1000 and 10,000 places are given. Sum of odd numbers. Sum of odd numbers.
Here, sum of even numbers.
You can write places, just now I said odd places,
even places.
Which are odd places? First one, don't know. One more odd place. Two odd places we don't know. See, both the odd places we don't know. Third one we know. Third one is odd place, four. See children, first odd place don't know, second odd place don't know, third odd place is four. Next, even places, add even places. First even place is two, second even place is five. One more even place? No, it is not there. So here, 2 plus 5 is 7. There is no blank. There is no blank in the even places.
There is no blank in the even places.
Only the odd places we should find out. If it is 7, if you want this number is to be divisible by 11, both answers should be equal. That we should know. Both answers should be equal. If I got 7 means, here also it should be 7. This is very important children. I got here 7 means, this also should be 7. To get this 7, only 4 is there. To get this 7, you can write 2, 4 plus 2, 6, plus 1, 7, see. 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 4, 7. Or you can do like this also. How? 4, this is 2, this is 1. We got the numbers now. Which numbers? This number is 1. The number which is asked here, this is 1. And this odd, next odd is 2. This is 1 and this is 2. How we got this? Added even places. 7 we got. If this is 7, this also should be 7. So already 4 it is there in the question. To get 7 in the two places, in these two empty places, 1 you should add 2, 4 plus 2, 6. To get 7, now it is only 6. One more if I want to add one more number. Right, children? So this is how your first exercise here. This is lesson number 1, practice question of lesson number 1, divisibility test by 11. Right, children? After this, we'll move towards lesson 2 under block 6, that is finding HCF by common division method. Lesson number 2 will start after this, that is finding HCF. That is totally different. Here, no HCF we found. Now starts in lesson number 2. We will find the HCF by common division method. Understood, children? Okay.